So what's going on, guys? It's JM, it's Speedbox here. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel before you click on 20 of the videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So, former British heavyweight champion and highly ranked world contender Dillian the Body Snatcher White will apparently be fighting again in the summer, and Eddie Hearn is trying to make Dillian White have his debut in the United States very soon in his next fight, and he's trying to put Dillian White on the undercard of Terence Crawford and Julius Ndongo, because in that fight Eddie Hearn will be promoting Julius Ndongo. That was part of his contract. If he defeated Ricky Burns, Julius Ndongo, well, Eddie Hearn has to promote Julius Ndongo in his next fight, and he's doing that, and he's trying to match him up with Terence Crawford. Bob Arum obviously will be promoting Terence Crawford. So yeah, that's very interesting. Apparently that fight is still going to be for the undisputed light welterweight title, Terence Crawford and Julius Ndongo, even though apparently Julius Ndongo was about to be stripped of his IBF title for not fighting his mandatory lipinets. But anyway, on to Dillian White. Dillian White was meant to fight Marius Wack on June the 3rd, but didn't, pulled out with a back injury. And I think that would have been a good test for Dillian White. Marius Wack, former world title challenger, very tough man with an iron chin, and he fought Alexander Povetkin as well a couple of fights ago, Marius Wack. So that would have been a very interesting fight, but Dillian White pulled out of that fight, and then Derek Chisora pulled out of his fight with Robert Hellenius, and I thought that was a bit sus. And then it turned out Dillian White agreed to fight Derek Chisora on July the 1st, but couldn't come to terms with Derek Chisora and his people, or Eddie Hearn couldn't, his promoter. So it'll be interesting to see who Dillian White will face in the United States. He says he wants to fight with Joseph Parker, the WBO heavyweight champion, and I'm thinking somebody like Christian Hammer could be a good opponent for Dillian White. Christian Hammer is a fighter who's going through an Indian summer of his career. He was a high level amateur, Christian Hammer, and he was a good fighter, and then he fought Tyson Fury in 2015 and got totally dominated. And then since then he's been having some good wins over guys like Erkin Teppor, former European heavyweight champion, David Price. In his last fight he beat a fringe contender as well, Erkin Teppor. So he's just going through slowly, Christian Hammer, and he's number two with the WBO. So if Dillian White could face Christian Hammer and beat him, then Dillian White would have a high ranking with the WBO, and he would likely be more in line for the Joseph Parker fight. And also a fight I've been thinking about as well is a Bob Arum fighter who is a heavyweight, Andy Ruiz Jr. If Bob Arum's co-promoting the show with Eddie Hearn, why not have Dillian White and Andy Ruiz Jr.? I think that could be a very good fight. You've got Andy Ruiz Jr., former heavyweight title challenger, hasn't fought since he lost his bid to become heavyweight title against Joseph Parker last December. And Andy Ruiz is a very good fighter. If you look at Andy Ruiz, you wouldn't think he was, because he's a really out of shape kind of fighter, but he's got incredibly fast hands. He puts pressure on you, he hits hard. Andy Ruiz Jr., he's a very talented boxer going forward. His defense is a bit but he does look like he's got a very good chin. So I think that could be a good fight for Dillian White as well. Obviously, you've got guys like Brian Jennings as well and Dominic Brazil. They could be good fights for Dillian White, but I doubt they'll be on Bob Arum shows, because Bob Arum don't fuck with Al Haymon. We all know that. So yeah, there are some interesting fights for Dillian White in the heavyweight division right now. Also, you've got guys like Johan Duopo, and even the Marius Wack fight, if it's still there, why not put Dillian White in there with Marius Wack? If Marius Wack's still open for the fight, why not have it in the States? Dillian White could put on a good performance and get his face shown around on a big card in America. So yeah, Dillian White says he wants a rematch with Anthony Joshua as well, and he's trying to become a world champion so he could get a shot at Anthony Joshua again. Anthony Joshua says all the time he wants a fight with Dillian White again. So it'll be very interesting to see what Dillian White will do going forward. I hope his next fight is a big fight, because he needs to be en route now to be trying to get a heavyweight title shot. So he needs to be facing higher level opponents, Dillian White, and even a Derek Chisora rematch. Like, why not? Because Derek Chisora, in a lot of people's mind, beat Dillian White. Like, I had Dillian White losing that fight against Derek Chisora when they fought on the undercard of Anthony Joshua, Everett Molina. So, yeah, there's so many unanswered questions with Dillian White, but we'll see in the upcoming months where Dillian White will be going in his career. Will it be a step too far trying to get to world level, or will Dillian White pass with flying colours? Comment below in the comment section. It's JM at Sweet Boxing.